Hey guys, welcome back to another tutorial. In this demo, I wanted to kind of show an idea of how to get a molten material to kind of melt text. So this is an effect that doesn't really exist natively in After Effects. There is the CC Mr. Mercury effect, which is a decent effect, but it doesn't emit from the alpha, kind of just emits everywhere, which makes it a little bit more annoying to use. So I'm going to show you some very simple techniques to get particles to kind of drip, that kind of look a little bit more viscous. That said, there are plugins out there that are going to be able to achieve this effect in a lot better way, like you will actually be able to track the texture a lot better, gonna change the viscosity of the fluid. But I think this is gonna be a pretty decent way to get a pretty close result. All right, so if that sounds good, let's get started. All right, so let's make a new composition. Here I'm using UHD 4K, 30 FPS and 150 frames. That'll be more than we need, but that's fine. Let's go to the type tool. Now for this, I do recommend using a font that is a bit thicker. If you use a really thin font, this is not really gonna work particularly well. I'm gonna import a gold texture. I'm gonna take that texture underneath my text layer here, change the track mat to alpha. And then on the text, we'll grab a simple choker effect. We'll just have this hold for about a second, so about 30 frames or so. And then we'll start animating this. This will just give us a little bit of a handle. We'll click U to see the keyframes, and then we'll go forward 2 seconds, so frame 90. And then the choke mat, we'll set that to negative 100. And what the simple choker is gonna do, it's gonna allow the borders of the alpha to expand, and then it kind of looks like it's melting into itself, which is a pretty cool effect. Now we can further this by adding a roughen edges effect. Now on the roughen edges, at frame 30, we can make sure the border is at 0. And then at frame 90, we can say this is something like 60, kind of roughens that border up a little bit. Then on the scale, we can increase the scale, maybe something around 150. Now we can also make that move and grab an evolution effect, hold down Alt and click the stopwatch, and then we'll set an expression, something like time times 90. So every second it goes 1/4 revolution to give it a little bit of extra motion there. And then for the interior itself, the actual gold itself, we can add a little bit of motion there with a turbulent displacement effect. So for the size, we'll do something like 20. And then for the evolution, we'll add another expression. We'll do time times 360. So every second it goes one full revolution. Let's kind of add some extra motion. It kind of makes it look like it's in liquid form already, or it's about to start kind of melting down, right? So we can take both of these, pre-compose them, and call this exactly what it is, text with texture. So next we can grab a solid. We'll use this as a mat. Turn this layer off, zoom out, grab a rectangular mask tool. Let's kind of roughly go over like this. At frame 30, we can set a keyframe here on the mask path. And then by frame 120 or so, we'll just pull this down so it's underneath here. So on the text with texture layer, change the track mat to alpha. And now we've got just a simple wipe. Now, the reason I don't use the linear wipe effect is this is a lot more robust. So for one thing, you could add multiple different masks and have them all at different rates. So you could have each letter kind of melt individually if you wanted to. Or you can add a roughen edges effect to it, which will make that line no longer perfectly straight, kind of just give it a little bit of variation. Again, we can add a time expression to the evolution. We'll do something like 90 again. So as that mask comes down, it's not perfectly straight, kind of adds a little bit more detail to it. Could also increase the scale, something like 250, make that a little bit smoother. Okay, now to really make this look like it's going to melt down, we really need to stretch out this text. So on the text with texture, let's grab a CC scale wipe effect. And for this, we'll change the direction to 180 degrees. And then at frame 30, set a keyframe with the stretch at 0. Click U to see your keyframes. And because this matte edge is going a little bit quick, what we're gonna do is just disable the mask really fast so we can see what we're doing. Change the stretch here to about 15, when it pulls it down a little bit. And then by frame 120, we could pull that down to about 25. So it goes a lot further, something like that. Now, this is a pretty cool effect just to use on its own, but we are gonna go ahead and actually get those dripping particles. Now we can go back to this mat, change the track mat back to alpha, and then we do need to reposition this. So at about frame 90, we need to pull up this mask so it's about there or so, just so it doesn't go quite so quickly. And then we can go back and tweak those if we need to. All right, so then what we can do, take these layers and pre-compose these. And we'll call that text with texture and matte. It's best to be wordy if it at least makes sense. When you start doing pre-comps inside of pre-comps, it gets very, very confusing. All right, so at this point, what we can do, we can make a duplicate of this. And on the duplicate, we can call this particles. We can grab a CC Particle Systems 2 effect. Make sure you grab the Particle Systems 2 and not CC Particle World, because we need one of the features that this one has that World does not. Then we're going to open up Particle, Physics, and Producer. So the very first thing here, let's change the particle type to Faded Sphere. Change the max opacity to 100%. Birth size, we'll keep that at about 0.2, and then the depth size, we'll also keep that at 0.2, so they're all the same. For the opacity map, we'll say constant. For the physics animation, instead of doing explosive, we'll do direction, and then we'll change the velocity to 0. So we just want these to go straight down. And by doing that, we've kind of confined the area with which this kind of emits to a really, really small sphere. So on the radius X, I want to make sure that you pull this out, and then on the radius Y, I'm going to do the same thing. If you keep this value too low later on, when the particles are supposed to be kind of emitting from the area where this kind of stretches out, they'll kind of stop and you'll kind of wonder why there's no particles there. So make sure the emitter is large enough. But if you make it too large, you really have to increase your birth rate to see those particles. All right, so the most important thing here is the source alpha inheritance. So click on this. And this means that the particles are only going to emit where there's pixels occupying the alpha channel. If we toggle our alpha here, you can see that anywhere where there are no pixels in the alpha, there's going to be no particles emitting from that. All right, so at frame 30, we can change our birth rate to 0, set a keyframe, and then by frame 60, we can increase this to something like 500, something kind of like that. To make this kind of look like these are all kind of one piece, I'm going to grab roughen edges again. We increase the border to about 25, and this is going to make it look like these are all kind of connecting to each other, kind of dripping from each other. You can also increase the scale to about 200. And then on the evolution, we can again add time expression. You could do something like time times 180, just so they're always going to be moving a little bit. And then after that, we're going to add a turbulent displace. And on the turbulent displace, we'll lower the amount down by half. And on the evolution on this, we could do the same thing. Now these are dripping a little bit too fast. So I'm gonna go to the gravity, just lower the gravity by about a third. So if you wanna make it look a little bit more viscous, just lowering the gravity helps quite a bit. Right, so I'm gonna collapse this particles layer, pull this underneath text with texture and matte, and then I'm gonna grab a copy of this gold texture. Now on the gold texture, I'll change the track matte to alpha. And basically now this looks like it's just one continuous texture that's falling. So this is the idea. This is what we actually want to achieve here. Now, because the texture doesn't move, we need to manually animate this. So starting at frame 20, click P for position. And I'm actually going to pull this up a little bit to like here. Set a keyframe at frame 30 is how we started this. Frame 30. And then at the very end, by about frame 120, we'll pull this whole thing all the way to the bottom. And we may have gone a little bit too fast there. Pull this up a little bit more. We could always use a repetile effect to keep that going if we needed to kind of repeat that a little bit. And then there's other areas right here. Like if you realize that you really want to make sure that this always looks darker, you could tweak the color correction of this part of the text if you wanted to, or you could just lift this up a little bit higher to begin with. And then that will look pretty good. Now, farther into the comp, you'll notice that as the text, the original text with texture and matte, that gets pulled down, the texture also stretches. So to mimic that, what we want to do, just grab like a directional blur. The direction is fine. So then on the blur length at frame 30, set it at 0. And then probably by frame 100, just so we can still see this on the screen, we could increase that to maybe 20 or so. And that'll probably look pretty good. We could probably pull this out to here now. Maybe a little lower, but that should be fine. Okay, another thing that I've noticed is we have a really hard edge on the text with texture and matte. You can see that's really, really sharp. So we can add a channel blur to fix that. So grab a channel blur, and on the alpha blurriness, frame 30, we can animate this starting at 0, and then maybe by frame 60 or so, that can get to a value of 20. Make sure you click repeat edge pixel, so otherwise you will never see the result. So that helps a little bit. We don't see that hard edge anymore. All right, so to make this look a little bit more like molten metal. I'm gonna grab a CC glass effect, but first we're gonna make a new adjustment layer called the CC glass, and then grab a CC glass effect. Pull this over. Now what this does, it kind of makes everything look just a little bit more like molten liquid. This makes it look like it's bubbling up a little bit. So for the bump map, we can just set that to non. We can just have affect everything. That's fine. And then for the height, if we increase that to something like 50, you can really begin to see kind of these bubbles that emerge. Kind of makes it look like it's a little bit more lifted off the surface. There's also lighting and shading parameters that you could change. Like if you wanted this to be a little bit brighter, you could increase the specularity. This is metal. But if you wanted to have this as something else, like plastic or something, you can change the metal to zero, and then it's going to look a little bit more plasticky. Okay, for now though, I'm just going to leave the shading as it is. And then at frame 30, we'll set the height to about 10, just so it's always there. And then maybe by about frame 60, we can have that go to 50. And I think that will just help make it look a little bit more interesting. You can also increase the displacement amount if you wanted to, and doing that kind of adds a lot more like stringy bits, but I kind of like it at the default setting, so I'm just going to leave it like that. And next, what we can do is take all of these layers and then pre-compose all of these. Call this text with particles. And at this point, what I'd like to do is grab a background. So I'll just import a background image here. Pull this underneath, grab a hue and saturation effect, drop the saturation down to zero. I'm also going to scale this entire layer down. Grab a vignette effect. I'm also grab a curves, but I'll put the curves in between the hue and saturation and the vignette. I'll just pull this down, something more like that. Duplicate the text with particles layer, call this glow. We can grab a fast blur, a fast box blur effect. Increase that up to about 100. Pull that underneath, then change the blending mode to screen. On the text with particles layer, we're going to grab a glow. Now, if you use the standard After Effects glow, not the greatest effect, you'll want to increase the radius probably to about 100, and then you'll want to drop down the intensity quite a lot. This can very easily clip though, so you want to make sure that the operation would be set to screen, just so it doesn't clip. You go to your info tab and just hover over these. They should never go above 1 on a 32-bit working space. If I change this to add, you can see that these go way beyond 1. So that means the values are clipped, and clipping is something you want to avoid. It just looks very unattractive, and it makes it very, very difficult to do other color corrections in the future if someone else is working on it. I'm actually not going to use this glow effect. I'm going to use a different one. I'm going to use one called Real Glow. This is a plugin, but it handles glow a lot better. It has more natural fall off. Drop down the intensity there. Next, we can probably lower this glow, but I am going to add some color correction first. New adjustment layer, grab a curves effect. We're just going to kind of lower the shadows a bit, pull up some of those highlights just a tad, thing more like that. Now this other glow might be just a little bit strong, this one, but it is needed. We do need a little bit of that. Just lower the opacity a little bit. Or you could go into the fast blur and you just lower the blur amount. So the last thing I want to do is add some heat distortion. So this would also go on a new adjustment layer. Now, basically with heat distortion, you can start off with a turbulent displacement effect. You could use a mat of some type of heat distortion effect and just use a displacement map, but I'm actually going to use a plugin. So you might want to look up how to create realistic heat distortion in After Effects. I'm using a Video Copilot plugin called Heat Distortion here. It does a very good job. I really like the effects that it gives, and it saves a lot of time. All right, so the very last thing I want to do is just do some quick camera zoom. I'll grab all these layers, just pre-compose these again. Call this camera zoom. And this is gonna be very simple. It's gonna scale this, and by the very end, about frame 120, let's go in about 10%. That will also hide any imperfections that you see at the edge. Go into the graph editor here, and we can just do an ease in and ease out. At the very beginning here, I don't want this to be already melting. So we're gonna go all the way back to that very original comp that we made. And we're gonna change the border of rough and edges. I meant to animate this, so it should start at 0, and by frame 90, it gets to 60. So it actually starts like that. Make sure you go into your text with particles comp. You need to enable motion blur on for all of your different layers, and make sure it's enabled for the composition as well. And that will simulate motion blur. Now, if you realize at the end there still isn't enough motion blur, which can happen with particles, you can add a CC force motion blur effect. It takes a ridiculous amount of time to render. It does require quite a lot of samples to get it to look decent, but that is another alternative for you. All right, so here's the final result. Now you'll notice the M is a little bit different. I just made the texture a little bit larger so it was more golden everywhere and it didn't get so dark. And then I also changed the timing of the mask that falls, just because in the demo I realized it was a little bit quick. Anyway, if you guys have any questions, feel free to post a comment. If you learned something, it would help me a lot if you click like. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Peace.